Dear viewers, Drishti IAS welcomes you to the new episode of Classical Dances of India. Let's begin with a brief introduction of Classical Dances of India. The prominent sources of classical dances are as follows. Natya Shastra. Author of Natya Shastra is Bharat Muni. Natya Shastra is also known as the Fifth Veda. Abhinay Darpan. Author of Abhinay Darpan is Acharya Nandikeshwar. Nataraja, idol of Shiva, is the symbol of classical dance. Basic foundation of classical dance are the mudras mentioned in Natya Shastra. Indian classical dances have two basic aspects. First one, Tandav. It denotes movement and rhythm. It is symbolic to the male aspects of dance. Secondly, Lasya. It denotes grace, bhav, ras and abhinay. It is symbolic to the feminine aspect of dance. Three main components of Indian classical dances are as follows. Natya. It is a dramatic component of the dance. The story is elaborated through the dance recital. Nritya. It is basic dance step. And third one, Nritya. It is an expressional component of dances, that is, mudras or gestures. Guru Shishya Parampara forms the core of Indian classical art form. There are 8 classical dances in India, which are as follows. Bharatanatyam, Kathakali, Mohini Yattam, Kuchipudi, Odissi, Manipuri, Satriya and Kathak. Point to be noted is that Sangeet Natak Academy has recognized 8 classical dance forms, whereas the Ministry of Culture has recognized 9 classical dance forms, including Chhau. Now let's have a look at the classical dances of South India. First one, Bharatanatyam from Tamil Nadu. Looking at the brief introduction, it is the oldest among all classical dance forms for about 2000 years plus old. It derives its names from Bharat Muni and Natyam, which means dance in Tamil. In the early days, Devdasis performed dance and music in front of idol of the Lord. Hence, it was also known as Sadir or Dasi Attam. Bharatanatyam dance is known to be Ekaharya, where one dancer takes on many roles in a single performance. Now looking on to the features of the same. In Bharatanatyam dance, special emphasis is on dance acting and body posture. The repertoire of Bharatanatyam is extensive. Repertoire means the list of performances. The repertoire of Bharatanatyam include Alaripu, Jati Swaram, Shabdam, Tilna, etc. Bharatanatyam starts with Alaripu, which means to adorn with flowers. It ends with Tilna, in which dance gestures are shown with the beauty of women. The music of Bharatanatyam belongs to the Carnatic system of southern India. The accompanying orchestra consists of vocalist, amridangam player, violinist or veena player, a flutist and a cymbal player. The person who conducts the dance recitation is the Natuvanar. Famous proponents of Bharatanatyam are Yamini Krishnamurti, Sonal Mansingh, Mrinalini Sarabhai and Mallika Sarabhai. Now moving on to Kathakali dance, Kerala. Now shifting to the introduction of Kathakali dance. It has evolved from many social and religious theatrical forms which existed in the southern region in ancient times. Kathakali is influenced by Chakiyar Kuthu, Kudiyattam, Krishnattam and Ramanattam. Looking at the features of Kathakali, dancers perform the characters of Ramayana, Mahabharata and Puranas. Kathakali is a mixture of dance, music and acting and dramatizes stories. Facial gestures, eye and eyebrow movements. Special emphasis is on the expression of cheeks, nose and chin. There are two types of characters in this dance. Hero or Pacha and the villain, that is Kathi. Color indication in Kathak is green for virtue and dignity, रेड इज फॉर सिन, ब्लैक इज फॉर तामसिक, येलो इज फॉर सात्विक एंड राजसिक. कथक इज प्रेविलेंट इन केरला एज वेल एज इन कर्नाटका रीजन. फेमस प्रोपोनेंट्स ऑफ कथक आर कलमंडलम रमन कुट्टी नायर, रीटा गांगुली, सदानम कृष्ण कुट्टी. नाउ लेट्स हैव अ लुक एट मोहिनीअट्टम डांस फ्रॉम केरला. शिफ्टिंग टू द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ मोहिनीअट्टम डांस, मोहिनीअट्टम इज इंटरप्रेटेड एज द डांस ऑफ मोहिनी. मोहिनी इज द सेलेस्टियल एनचेंट्रेस ऑफ द हिंदू माइथोलॉजी. इट इज बिलीव्ड दैट दिस डांस फॉर्म डेवलप्ड फ्रॉम द स्टोरी ऑफ विष्णु हु टुक द गाइज ऑफ मोहिनी टू किल भस्मासुरा. इट वॉज स्ट्रक्चर्ड इन टू द प्रेजेंट डे क्लासिकल फॉर्मैट बाय द ट्रेवनकोर किंग्स महाराजा कार्तिका तिरुनल एंड हिज सक्सेसर महाराजा स्वाति तिरुनल. मोहिनीअट्टम हैज इवॉल्व्ड थ्रू अ लॉन्ग प्रोसेस ऑफ एवोल्यूशन. It traces its origin to the temples of Kerala, though the exact period of its origin is not known. But there are evidences to prove the existence of a community of female temple dancers who assisted the temple rituals by adding expressive gestures to the mantras chanted by the temple priest. References of Mohiniyattam can be found in the following texts. Vyavahar Mala. Author of Vyavahar Mala is Mazamagalam Narayanan Namputiri. Ghosh Yatra. Author of Ghosh Yatra is Kunjan Nambiar. The Prince Swati Tirunal of Travancore was one of the chief architects of the dance in the 19th century and composed a large repertoire of songs which accompany the performance. Large repertoire of songs which accompany the performance. Now let's have a look at the features of Mohiniyattam dance. It is a classical solo dance form of Kerala. The gestures and facial expressions are closer to the natural and the realistic than to the dramatic or rigidly conventional. It generally narrates the story of the feminine dance of Vishnu. It belongs to the Lasya style, which is feminine, tender and graceful. It has no heavy steps or rhythmic tension. The footwork in Mohiniyattam is gentle, soft and sliding. The dancer's body rises and falls with an easy grace, with the emphasis mainly on the torso. Restraint in movement is the hallmark of the dance. Instruments used in Mohiniyattam are mridangam, veena, flute and manjira. Famous proponents of Mohiniyattam are Vaijanti Mala, Hema Malini, Sunanda Nair, Gopika Verma and Pallavi Krishnan. Now moving on to Kuchipudi dance of Andhra Pradesh. Moving on to the introduction of Kuchipudi, it was originated from Andhra Pradesh. It grew largely as a product of Bhakti movement beginning in the 7th century AD. It derives its name from the village Kuchelapuram, where it was nurtured by great scholars and artists. It emerged out of a long, rich tradition of Kuchipudi dance drama. Siddhendra Yogi formalized and systematized the tradition. He authored Bhamakalpam and many other plays. Features of Kuchipudi are: the central theme of Kuchipudi are the stories of Bhagavat Puran. It involves difficult foot movements. Emphasis in the Kuchipudi is on the dynamics of the movement and expressionism of feeling. Kuchipudi dance is accompanied by Carnatic music. Presently, Kuchipudi is performed either as solo, duet or group presentation. But historically, it was performed as a dance drama, with several dancers taking different roles. There are now two forms of Kuchipudi: traditional musical dance drama and solo dance. There are some popular solo elements in Kuchipudi. Some of them are Banduk Shabdam, which tells the story of a frog. Tarangam, the dancer performs with his or her feet on the edges of a brass plate and balancing a pot of water on the head or a set of diyas. Jal Chitra Nrityam, in this the dancer draws pictures on the floor with his or her toes while dancing. Principal instruments used in Kuchipudi dance are violin and mridangam. The recital is in Telugu language. Famous proponents of Kuchipudi are Radha Reddy and Raja Reddy, Yamini Krishnamurti, Indrani Rahman, etc. Now let's see the classical dances of Eastern and Northeastern India. First one is Odissi dance from Odisha. Looking at the brief introduction, the sources of Odissi dance are the caves of Udaygiri and Khandagiri. It derives its name from the Odra Nritya mentioned in Natya Shastra. It was performed as a part of temple service by meharis or female temple servants. It was primarily practiced by the meharis and patronized by the Jain king Kheravela. In the mid-20th century, Odissi gained international acclaim due to the efforts of Charles Fabry and Indrani Rahman. It is inscribed at the sun temples of Konark. Now moving on to the features of Odissi dance. The dance form symbolizes the element of water. The lyrics of Gita Govind, written by Jaydev, are used along with the composition of some local poets. The woman dancer wears an elaborate hairstyle, silver jewelry, long necklace, etc. It is similar to Bharatanatyam in the use of mudras and postures to express emotions. The movements are soft and graceful. The techniques of movement are built around the two basic postures of chok and tribhanga. The chok is a position mimicking a square. It depicts masculinity. The tribhanga, that is, three-banded form of the body. The body is deflected at the neck, torso and the knees. It depicts femininity. The dancers create complex geometrical shapes and patterns with the body. Hence, it is known as mobile sculpture. Odissi dance is accompanied by Hindustani classical music. Instruments used in Odissi dance are manjira, that is cymbals, pakhwaj, that is drums, sitar, flute, etc. Famous proponents of Odissi dance are Guru Pankaj Charandas, Guru Mohapatra, Sonal Mansingh, Sharon Lovin from USA, Anandini Dasi from Argentina. Now moving on to Manipuri dance of Manipur. Shifting towards the introduction of Manipuri dance, it evolved in Manipur in northeastern India. Mythological origin of Manipuri dance is the celestial dance of Shiva and Parvati in the valleys of Manipur, along with the local Gandharvas. It gained prominence with the advent of Vaishnavism. Features of Manipuri dance are, it is performed generally by females. Emphasis in Manipuri dance is on devotion and not sensuality. The artist never establishes eye contact with the audience. It incorporates both Tandav and Lasya. Nagbandha Mudra is an important posture in the Manipuri dance form. In Nagbandha Mudra, the body is connected through curves in the shape of 8. Various forms of this dance are Rasleela, Sankirtana and Thangata. In Rasleela, the dance based on Radha, Krishna and Gopis. In Sankirtana, male dancers bow down and play pank and kartal while dancing. In Thangata, battle scenes are displayed. Instruments used in Manipuri dance are pank, flute, kartals, dholes, etc. Famous proponents of Manipuri dance are Guru Bipin Singh, Guru Nabh Kumar, N. Madhabi Devi, Jhaveri sisters Nayana, Suvarna, Ranjana and Darshana. Now moving on to Satriya dance of Assam. Moving on to the introduction, it was introduced in the 15th century AD by the great Vaishnava saint and reformer of Assam, Mahapursha Sankara Deva. It derives its name from the Vaishnava monasteries known as Satras. It was primarily practiced in Satras. The Satras were established for the propagation of Vaishnavism. It is inspired from Bhakti movement. Now moving on to the features of Satriya dance. It is an amalgamation of various dance forms prevalent in Assam, mainly Ojapali and Devdasi. It is a combination of music, dance and acting. It was developed by Shankar Dev for performing Ankiya Nat. Ankiya Nat is a type of Satriya. It involves play or musical drama. The emphasis on Satriya dance is on hand gestures, use of steps, movement and expression. The dance is generally performed in the group by male monks known as Bhokods. It received the status of classical dance in the year 2000. Instruments used in Satriya dance are khol or drum, cymbals or manjira, and flute. Famous proponents of Satriya dance are Ramakrishna Talukdar, Krishnakshi Kashyap. Now let's have a look at the classical dance of Northern India, that is Kathak. Shifting towards the introduction, a principal dance of Northern India, which is widely practiced in Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Delhi, Madhya Pradesh, and even parts of Western and Eastern India today. Kathak is associated with the Rasleela tradition of Brajbhumi in Uttar Pradesh. The word Kathak has been derived from the word Katha, which means a story. Now moving on to the features of Kathak dance. In Kathak dance, emphasis is mainly on the hand gestures and footwork. It is expressed through Dhrupad and Thumri music. It is also called Natwari dance. Jugalbandi is the main attraction of Kathak recital, which shows a competitive play between the dancer and the tabla player. Kathak is also related to Iranian and Muslim culture in classical dances. Major gharanas of Kathak dance are Jaipur gharana, Lucknow gharana, Banaras gharana and Raigarh gharana. Instruments used in Kathak dance are tabla, pakhwaj, sarangi etc. Famous proponents of Kathak dance are Pandit Birju Maharaj, Sitara Devi, Pandit Jayalal and Pandit Sitaram Prasad. So that's all for today. Stay tuned for the next episode. Till then, stay home, stay safe.